So I'm not sure how you get to this level of dirty and drive it every single day, but this Nissan Frontier was driven daily by a construction contractor, and the smell alone was something that would have set off alarms, but I guess if you get used to it and just driving it around, it's something you completely forget about, and this is the result of years of neglect and just not really caring for your vehicle. But we're gonna go ahead and transform this thing real quickly by just removing everything from the car to get started and start the vacuuming and extraction process. And you guys will be shocked by the end of this video how good this thing turned out. This Nissan Frontier is one of those old school kind of cab style ones with the jump seats in the back, which is something I don't think they quite make like they used to, especially at this size. They're even a small truck is bigger than this one now. But yeah, let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna stop talking. Minshine APC is back in stock, so if you've been waiting for it to come back in, it is ready for order. I have a ton of inventory. I ordered extra for you guys to make sure there was plenty of volume for the next several months, so make sure you pick it up. And I also have a coupon code down below so you guys can save a little extra that watch these videos are loyal supporters. And if you are new, hit that subscribe button and join Stauffer Garage. I have these videos that come out every single week, so you guys can learn tips and tricks on detailing along with just regular maintenance and care for your own vehicle so you can keep them clean and they don't ever get to the stages that you see in this video or all of the other ones. I've mentioned this before, but I still get questions about vacuuming. I spend a lot of time vacuuming. It is one of the longest stages of my detail besides the extraction, just because the more dirt I can pull out in this stage, the less work my extractor has to do and the less amount of passes I have to make, because the liquid, when you spray it onto the carpet or the seats, that dirt gets soaked in even further into the fibers. But if I vacuum it when it's dry, it just makes the mess in the actual extraction phase that much quicker. So I spend a lot of time vacuuming. There's a few little techniques that I use of using the smaller nozzle because of the velocity and the amount of restriction it causes. So it causes a higher suction power. There's just a few different little tricks that I figured out that speed up the amount of dirt extraction compared to using a larger nozzle head. We'll be right back. I want to ask you guys, if there was a certain type of video that you would like to see on this channel, let me know in the comments below. I want to start doing more details like this, obviously. This is kind of like my bread and butter. But in the back in the day, if you look at the very first videos on my channel, I did a car build type series. I wanted to get more into that when I initially started, but then it kind of evolved into detailing like you see now. But I want to do some different stuff. I want to try to add some different complexities to the channel, some different type of content, because I think the detailing side is really, really informative and helpful for you guys all and satisfying to watch. But also, car builds are kind of a passion of mine. Building a car from scratch, you know, swapping the motors, making high horsepower, you know, that sort of thing is something I've always done, but I've never really talked about or shown on this channel except for when I first started it. So if you want to see any different type of content, let me know in the comments below what you think. Now, if you have a detailing business and you are a mobile detailer, or you have your own detailing shop, or if you have any business in general that would be helpful for anybody that watches this channel, go ahead and comment down below what your business is and how they can reach you. I think it would just be great for everyone to kind of get, you know, that publicity and that ability to gain customers just from watching these videos. Because for me, I do a lot of customer cars. I've done, you know, 4 ceramic coatings in the last 2 weeks. That are just customer client cars that have come in through, you know, cold calls. But if you are detailing, say, in South Carolina, for instance, there's no way I'm going to be able to service that customer. So if you are a detailer in a different area, comment down below and leave your information, so that way anybody watching that wants to get their car cleaned up at this sort of level, or just a good solid detail in general, they'll have a way to reach out to you. So it's a free marketing opportunity for you. So go ahead and comment down below if you have a business that would be helpful for anybody watching. We'll be right back. Now, when it comes to the extraction phase, I always get asked, what is the liquid that I spray on? For that, it is a scoop of OxyClean in my 5-gallon sprayer that is filled with hot water. And then I also add 2 scoops of BioBrake, which is a carpet, more of an industrial type cleaner that's used in residential inside. I really like it because it breaks down a lot of organic compounds, which is the majority of what gets into seats, you know, butt juices and fun stuff like that. And it breaks down those oils really well, and it doesn't foam a ton. It foams initially with the drill brush, but when it comes to extracting, it doesn't fill up your extractor with foam. It just fills it up with dirty waste, yummy, delicious water. So that is the formula that I use, and I do have that link down below if you want to check it out. Someone is going to ask this question down below, but I'm going to go to answer it now. For me, the detail inside of this is not just YouTube videos for me. I actually do a lot of the details, like I mentioned earlier, for ceramic coatings the last 2 weeks. When it comes to ceramic coatings, that is a really high ticket item. It's a lot of labor because you have to do a lot of prep work and a lot of just the actual polishing phase can take a while if you're depending on how bad the car is. But from a profit margin standpoint, when you're doing details, I always try to price myself according with the market in the area that you're in. So look at detailers in your area. You can use that as a guide to figure out what kind of service they offer at what price. And then it depends if you're mobile or if you have your shop or you're working out of your garage. For instance, for me, I still do everything out of my garage, so it keeps my overhead super, super low. I don't have to pay, besides my mortgage for my house, which is fine. If I'm not paying for a shop, I'm not paying for all those utilities associated with a separate structure, I can also then price myself at a better price than anybody that has a shop. That's just common sense, right? So for me, when it comes to detailing, if you want to do this as a side hustle or you're full-time, just look at the full scope of what you offer, how you offer the service, and then use that overhead and just competitor analysis to figure out the price point that works best for you. Now, a trick here with the shifter, and if you have an automatic, if you manual, don't even respond because you know how to clean around your shift boot because you have the freedom to move the gears. But if you have an automatic, there's always a little tab that you can remove and use your key to stick into. Obviously, make sure your e-brake is on because when you shift, push that little button inside the little tab area, you can move that shifter without having to have the key in the car or the brake pressed or anything like that. But it allows you to clean that area extremely thoroughly. So that way you don't leave any of that area when you put into drive dirty at the end after you've done all this work. So that's just a little trick. It's used by dealerships to move cars, especially transporters when they're shuffling cars around from dealership to dealership. That's just an easy way for them to do it without having to turn on a car, especially with used cars, sometimes the battery being dead. Now, if you haven't heard already, I've kind of publicized it a little bit. I've kind of kept it a little bit on the down low, though. I have a car flipping course that I've created. It is a super cheap price. It's actually on foxcling.com. It's one of the tabs at the top. You'll see it. But it is an easy way for you to learn more about car flipping, all of the different methods that I use to acquire these cars, how I fix them up, the methods that I use, and then how to negotiate a sale price to make a little extra money on the side. It's something that I've learned over the last 4 years of just learning how to do it, but also the strategies that I utilized, I incorporated it all into that course and share that information for you. And I think right now I'm running a special of $7.99 for this course. So it's super affordable, super cheap. And if you're buying an all-purpose cleaner and just adding it on there, and if you're a detailer, it's just it's a way for me to give back that information for you at a very low price, and it allows you to learn more about the skill and trade of flipping cars if that is something that you're interested in. So after doing YouTube videos on detailing for 4+ years, this video on screen is one that you need to watch, because if you thought this was satisfying, this next video raises that bar even further. So go watch it now. Continue to watch more videos, because I can guarantee you, you have not seen them all. The next one will definitely be satisfying, and I'll see you guys next week.